episode of UK Predator Fishing. I was going to do a bit of place fishing today, but the water's too covered, so I'm going to give it a miss till next time. So I've resorted to coming back to the beach where I catch a lot of smoothbounds. I've got some prawns, so I'll probably put the rod out for them, and then I'll just chuck a worm rod out too and just see what I can pick up really. The wind is horrendous. It's quite open here, so hopefully the footage shouldn't be too bad. But yeah, we'll see how we get on. That's the first setup there, ready to go. It's really simple, just a bit of black lug on a 2-up clip down rig, 6-ounce dynamics because the tide looks pretty strong tonight. I'm just looking to pick up anything. I'll probably end up getting smooth rounds on that too because they take anything. So, fingers crossed I can get a place on it or something like that. Oh, so that'll be cool. Well, that's both rods in the water now. One's got prawn on, get a smooth round on that probably. One thing I just wanted to mention is if you're fishing on a beach and it's pretty windy and there's quite a lot of wave, keep your rods as close to the water as possible and put your tripods as high in the air as you can really. It'll stop the waves catching your line, which will give false bites, and it also will stop the weed from collecting on your line. Well, a lot of the weed anyway, so yeah. Just gonna cast this prawn bait out. Hopefully I can send it into the channel. The wind's blowing right in my face, so I'm struggling to get distance. Guys, first fish of the session. It's lovely smooth round, look at that, absolute beast. My rod nearly got taken in the water because I wasn't concentrating. I just weighed him, 11 pound 9 ounce, absolute bit of a huge head on him. He's got a big belly. What a fish that is. I'll get him back and we'll try and get a bigger one, but I'm not sure if we will tonight. What a beautiful fish that is, guys. Get this one back now, swim off. Off he goes. A bit of boost, he's in a bit of shallow water there. Oh, it's all going off at the moment. I just put that hound back. The other rod's got a bite now. Yep, fish on. I think it's another hound. Doesn't feel too bad either. this is just on worms, so I need to be quite careful with this one because the hook lengths aren't as strong as the pulley rigs. Only about 20 pound fluorocarbon. It's another decent sized one. Not quite as big as the last, but I won't say no. This one's probably only about £4, maybe not even that, but it's a lovely fish, loads of little stars on it. Their eyes are so cool, aren't they? Nice and green. Yeah, I was just baiting up my other rod then, and again, I didn't even notice. I need to start watching him more, don't I? Well guys, I've not really had a chance to sit down yet. It's always hard fishing with two rods when there's hounds around because they travel in packs, so there's just loads of them. I feel like at the start I would definitely say that crab is the best bait because that's what they follow in and feed on. But after a month, they feed on anything. But yeah, any kind of shellfish is really good. Prawn's brilliant. I think sometimes prawn actually does fish outfish crab, so for the price of it, why not give it a go. But yeah, I've got a bite on the prawn rod now. I'm just gonna let it develop a bit more. Had a good tap, I reeled into it, I haven't felt anything, so I'll leave it for a little bit. So yeah, I'm just gonna bait up another rig now, and we'll see what happens. Well, just had another really good bite. I don't touch less of it. No fish though, unfortunately. It's made a mess of that prawn, hasn't it? Just cast it back out, so hopefully we can hit the prawn soon. There we have it guys, thought I had a little place on, had a few little taps, just see it, just tapping away. I knew it wasn't a smooth hound, so yeah, I'm happy with that. Lovely fish, we'll get him unhooked, we'll get him back. Right guys, so this place has got quite deeply hooked here, so what you want to do is you want to get your forceps or along those pliers or whatever you've got. Go in between the gills, don't actually touch the gills. You want to be coming right out of his mouth, slide everything else up the line, all the beads and stuff. You want to grab the line there, pull it through. And what that does is it turns the hook on itself. Get rid of the worm out of the way. And look, the hook's there. And then you can unhook it like that. And to get it back through, rub the hook so it can't hook onto anything else. You just want to very gently get in between them gill covers again. Straight out the mouth of it, like that. There we go, unhooked, look. That is the best way of unhooking flatfish when they're deeply hooked. Getting back now. I'm happy with that. Both targets achieved. Straight off, look. I've literally just recorded a clip there to say that it's gone a bit quiet, and you'll see in the video my rod just started bending over. It's not as big as the other two, I don't think, but it's got some lovely patterns on it. Even though this is, I think this is my 105th hound this year now, and even though it is, you never get tired of catching these. Like, they put on such a good fight for what they are, and there's lots of them around too, so yeah, they keep you busy all night. So much power in them as well. It's got some beautiful markings on it. I give this, even though it's quite a small fish in length, I'd actually give it quite a bit of weight. It's got a bit of fat. Get it back now. Well, that's me for today, guys. A decent session. I had that double hound straight away. 11 pound 8 ounce, I think it was, and I had one a little bit smaller. I had a place, and I had another place as well, but it was bleeding quite badly because it was deep hooked, so I just wanted to get it back in the water really. It did actually swim off, so that's good. And then I had one more hound, so not a bad night really. It was a bit last minute, to be honest. I haven't really been out too much recently. I've just been busy with work and other things like that. So yeah, I will get some proper place fishing in soon. That's what I was going to do today, but it wouldn't have been any good. You can't really fish a place well while the water's coloured. It needs to be quite clear, so I think they're sight feeders. So yeah, I'll get that done in the next couple of weeks. Yeah, if you have liked this video, I'd appreciate it if you could give it a like and subscribe to the channel. Cheers for watching. I'll see you next time.